Amen. Yeah, give him a hand. Amen, amen. Thank you all. Well, good morning, Covenant.
Good morning.
Nice. We're going to do that one more time as I get this stand up here. Good morning, Covenant.
Good morning.
Lovely. Well, hello, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Alex Sergio. I'm the minister of congregational life here. And we're going through a sermon series called Sacred Earth, Sacred Worth. And you've been hearing sermons about creation spirituality. It's a type of spiritual focus that helps us deepen our spiritual life, helps us develop passion for justice and human transformation. And today, our scripture is Psalm 30, which I just read. And you know, folks, here's the problem. I really wasn't feeling it. You know, I really wasn't feeling our psalm today. You know when you can't pick up what someone else is putting down? You can't smell what someone else has stepped in? It's like church if you wanted a song about love, about passion, about the feeling of falling in love and all that brings. And then you get this song. Let's see if it comes out. Oh. This isn't right. No. Paul, cut it off. Cut it off. This isn't good. No, yeah, thank you, Paul. That's not a song about love and passion. That's no one's dancing to Mr. Lonely by Akon at their wedding. Or it's like this. The year is 1993. You're going to the movie theater to see one of the greatest movies possibly ever made, Jurassic Park. You sit in the theater, you expect to hear John Williams' swelling score, the dinosaurs are about to be shown. Woo! This is a great moment. But then this comes up. No, yeah, thank you, Paul. I'm glad you cut that off early. That would have ruined the movie for me, right? It feels off. It's not how I'm feeling in this moment. And, you know, it was tough to write this sermon because I felt stuck. I felt stuck because I was reading these beautiful words about the psalmist praising God for deliverance. How God had delivered the psalmist from harm and their enemies, and I just wasn't in the right space for it. And it's not where I am now. And the Psalms, just like music, are really for a time and a place and a feel. Talking about the Psalms today and discussing different paths of life is really appropriate because not every Psalm is like Psalm 30. Psalms are expressions of life. They are express how people felt in certain moments and situations. And gratitude and thankfulness isn't what everyone was feeling all the time. Let's take Psalm 44, for example. It's going to start hard. You ready? In talking about God, the psalmist is going to write this. You have rejected us and shamed us. You have not gone out with our armies. You made us turn back from the foe, and our enemies have gotten spoil. You have made us like sheep for a slaughter. You have scattered us among the nations. You have sold your people for a trifle, demanding no high price for them. You have made us the taunt of our neighbors, the derision and scorn of those around us. You have made us a byword among the nations, a laughingstock among the peoples. All day long, my disgrace is before me, and shame has covered my face. Ooh, and whoa. Now, here's the thing. Depending on how you're feeling this morning, that could feel right on. Or it could feel like someone trying to play harmonica over John Williams' score, right? Or how about Psalm 74? Oh God, why do you cast us off forever? Why does your anger smoke against the sheep of your pasture? Remember your congregation, which you have acquired long ago, which you redeemed to be the tribe of your heritage. Remember Mount Zion, where you came to dwell. Your foes have roared within your holy place. They set up their emblems there. The upper entrance they hacked with wooden trellises and axes. They said to themselves, we will utterly subdue them, and they burned all the meeting places of God in the land. Those psalms are a far cry from, O Lord, I cried to you for help, and you have healed me. Or, you've turned my mourning into dancing. You've taken off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy. And today, folks, I wonder where you're at. I wonder which psalm, which one of these psalms feels more right. Because both are options in the path of life. But it really depends on your context for why you may be lamenting or why you may be praising. So where does our psalm come from today? What is the context? Where has the psalmist been to have come to this place of celebration? At the beginning of each psalm, we get some context of where this may have been read or performed. In the introduction of Psalm 30 reads, a psalm of song in dedication to the temple. And hearing that, this psalm makes so much more sense. The temple was so wildly important to Israel's history. And knowing it, that it was read at a temple dedication means that Psalm 30 could also have been read in response to some deep tragedy. In Israel's history, the temple was the most important thing to them. It was an incredibly sacred place for these Jewish people. The Bible recalls that King Solomon built the first temple in 950 BCE. The ancient Israelites worshiped there, made sacrifices there, went there for confession, to be redeemed, for community, love, protection, and connection to God. It's the place that they literally felt heaven and earth connected in this one single space. And there it stood in Jerusalem until about 586 BCE, until the Babylonian exile. The Babylonian army took what was inside and burned down the rest. I wonder if Psalm 74 was written in response, because did you catch it? They said to themselves, we were utterly subdued them. They burned all the meeting places of God in their land. What had stood for over 300 years, a staple, a symbol for the Israelite people, was gone in only a matter of time. And into exile, the Israelite people went. Whoever wasn't initially killed upon the first sweep were moved into Babylon, where they were expected to learn Babylonian language and Babylonian customs and to give up the life that they once had. The Book of Lamentations is actually a collection of poems written from the ancient Israelite people speaking to this exile. They read about how terrible this time was. In Lamentations 1, we read, how lonely sits the city that once was full of people. How like a widow she has become, she that was great among the nations. She was like a princess among the provinces, and now she has become subject to slavery. She weeps bitterly in the night with tears on her cheek. Among all her lovers, she has no one to comfort her, and all her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They've become her enemies. And Psalm 30 probably would have looked more like Psalm 44 or 74 if that's where the story of Israel ended. But it wasn't the last note for the Israelites. They came back from the Babylonian exile and rebuilt a second temple in about 521. And I think it's there that I can imagine our psalm today. Can't you? The temple has been rebuilt. We're back where we need to be. We were mourning, But in the temple today, let's dance, baby. And I think it's there that I can imagine our psalm. Imagine a moment of hope and outpouring joy. And their vibe, so to speak, wasn't defeated. Their tone was celebratory. Their tone was victory. And even if I can come across this psalm in the stage of my life and feel like it applies to me, I can still appreciate and love the context that the psalm came from. I can appreciate that in times I want to celebrate, I feel delivered by God. And it's appropriate to talk about both Psalms and Lamentations today because they outline perfectly where the paths of life take us. Psalm 30 is this triumphant cry that God has delivered God's people. They're in a time of joy and victory. And also, within the same book, Psalms 44 and 74, wondering where God is, and even a little disappointed in God. Lamentations has cries of great pain and sadness, weeping and gnashing of teeth. And Lamentations has one of the most hopeful verses in all of the Bible. Maybe you've heard it before. We used to sing this song all the time in my youth group, and little did I know it was one of the saddest books of the Bible. It's the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him.
Why aren't you in the choir?
Thank you. From the same book. From the same book, we get two totally different vibes. Totally different feelings. Deep sadness and loss, doubt and fear, as well as overwhelming joy and happiness. Dancing and love, and here's the kicker, church. Both are good. Both are holy. Today, if you feel more connected to Psalm 30, be blessed. Go and move your contagious joy wherever you can. If today you feel more like Psalm 44 and 74, that's okay. Your emotions are not your enemy. Be honest with yourself and how you feel. It's okay to be sad. It's okay to be glad. We move through emotions like seasons in a year. God's Spirit compels us to move into those different paths of life. And the trick is to move in those rhythms with others. Even if someone's on a different path than you, even if you're Psalm 30 and they're Psalm 44, we don't need to save people from their sadness or yank people away from their happiness. That's okay if that's the journey they're on in this time and in this place. Together as community, we do one simple thing. Together as community, we simply walk alongside each other in all seasons of our lives, all paths of our faith, and all songs that our soul are singing. And the music someone else is feeling may sound off to you, but it doesn't mean it's wrong. Through sadness, love, joy, doubt, faith, whatever, together we walk step by step in a life that's full of mess, full of backtracking. But the goal isn't to be the first one to cross the finish line. It's to walk together. So church, wherever you're at, whether your faith has called you to dance or your faith has called you to be the frozen chosen, may we walk together. May we walk in love wherever the paths of life lead us. Amen.